If the principle of true art is not to portray, but to evoke, as one novelist put it, this two-story kiln-formed glass artwork inside the lobby of the newly constructed courthouse does just that.
Where there's art, there's hope, because it's a sign of life going on. The composition of the piece is very much about finding your way through that turmoil to the calmer waters, and in that there is hope in that journey, because there is a place to go to that's better.
The artwork does not have a name. That's left to the viewer to decide. But it was designed to evoke feelings of hope, possibility, and transformation. Painter and public artist Lynn Basa drew inspiration for her piece by talking to the very people who use this building.
What really made me connect to this project was when, as a finalist, during our orientation, we were introduced to people who had been through the justice system. They had been in prison and they'd gotten out. We had dinner with some of them, and talked to the judges, talked to the attorneys. So we really got a great orientation into what is going on literally behind the scenes. So that's when I started getting the idea of this, of the piece going from, it's very hot, the crime is hot, someone's life is in turmoil, and then gradually it becomes cooled down and calmed down. And so it becomes very much like you read it from left to right, and becomes a life in transition. So I see it when I talk to these people, I realize that there really is hope.
The courthouse includes artworks by some of the most notable artists in the Pacific Northwest, including many works by artists of color, women, and LGBTQ artists. Multnomah County worked with the Regional Arts and Culture Council to bring in artists with Northwest connections and to support local business. The kiln-formed colored glass used to create the piece was manufactured at Bullseye Glass through a centuries-old handcrafted process, combined with state-of-the-art equipment and filtration systems. The mural itself came to life by a multi-talented 5-member fabrication team at Bullseye Studio, charged with translating the original vision of the piece into the physics of the kiln-formed glass. Architectural fabricator Kristen Rawson helped lay down the roadmap for the mural by redrawing and anchoring color schemes for the more than 120 panels.
For me, in doing the drawings, I would lay down a grid and then basically just freehand draw all of the points in the panel that would help us anchor things, because the frit is very, as we lay down frit, we're making a lot of choices around what colors go where and how it flows together, and that doesn't translate in the drawing.
The team used a methodical process to work their way through panel by panel. Once drawn, crushed and grated colored sheet glass called frit was used to translate the painterly imagery for the mural. Samples and prototypes were tested to create a palette of more than 24 different color schemes.
We've got a pretty broad product line to choose from, and any colors that we don't make, we can create by blending them together. So just like you would be mixing paint in order to do a painting, we're using the same basic idea and combining the different single colors of frit together in order to create those painterly effects and those blends of color.
It's very much a team effort in the, when I hand off a drawing, when they start laying down frit, they have a lot of choice in how that looks and how they translate my drawing. So there's several stages of translation. I'm translating it onto a piece of glass, they're translating it using color, and we're all going from the same initial drawings so that we all have the same idea.
After a panel is drawn and frit is laid down, it's walked over to a kiln for the firing process.
We fire the pieces off in the kiln at about 1480 degrees Fahrenheit. And at that temperature, all of those individual granules of glass that are sitting on that base sheet of glass, all of that's becoming liquid enough that it can all fuse together into a single continuous panel.
The team worked 10 panels ahead to help ensure continuity. A project that took over a year to complete and several weeks to mount in the lobby of the new Central Courthouse.
Today is actually the first day I saw it in person after so many, it seems like years of living with it in my head and then making visits to Bullseye and seeing them making it, but there was just no way to comprehend the scale of it. Lots of times when I'm doing a public art commission, I've lived with it in my head for so long that by the time it's installed, I feel like I've already seen it, but not with this one because the scale is just so huge. I wanted everybody who came in, you know, not to feel intimidated by it, but to also feel kind of awestruck, but that they could relate to it too.
The thing that I've enjoyed most about this project is really finding ways to make glass read like paint and to find the depth and find the way the colors kind of roll together. This is not just a simple landscape painting. It has depth to it, and there's colors that are bubbling up through other colors.
The landscape is meant to reflect the rippling passage of time through redemption and rehabilitation.
In the context of the criminal justice system, the composition does have to do with stepping stones, which is a metaphor that some of the people who I talked to who had been through the system had talked about, how they had to just like follow these stepping stones through this morass of temptation to fall back to wherever they were.
The fact that they were able to translate my work so faithfully into glass, every single square inch of that piece had to capture the feeling of the medium that I work in. Tom Jacobs at Bullseye is just a genius at that.